We're so happy to have all of you with us. We're so excited you could all come and celebrate our wonderful seniors. We know all of you are here because you love them just as much as we love them.
Exactly.
To give a little explanation, this concert's going to be different than the other ones. If you can't already tell, we're very chill because
we're not at our crazy MC level. I know you might miss that.
Because you know what? It's not about us.
Unlike the previous concert.
No, not that. But you know what I mean. You know what I mean, everyone. We are here to cry for our seniors. I don't see tears from every one of you. Something went wrong.
So the format of tonight's concert is we're going to have three songs we've prepared. That we've been working on, just like in our previous concerts. Everyone, or like some Notes and Keys members, will be giving speeches for each of the seniors, and then the seniors will sing their senior solo. Very exciting, and we might have a little bit of a surprise for everyone at the end, TBD. So to kick it off, we will be playing Best Part. The only, yeah, wait, no, it's this one, which is exciting. It's not, yes. I'm not as like tech savvy as Maisie, and I'm the one sharing it. It's gonna have to.
No, that's not where you do it, right here.
Oh, true.
Without further ado.
Oh, should I make it like full screen?
Yeah.
Oh, that's okay.
Quick time.
Probably should have muted.
Right there. Perfect. Oh.
Okay, so, oh wait, I have to share something. Okay.
Best part. If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? Love me, won't you say something? Say something.
Gave us chills. Wow. Give it up for our two wonderful senior soloists there, Nathan and Uwa. You guys killed that.
Incredible.
I'm definitely going to miss hearing you two sing that song.
It's okay, but at least we have that recording.
True. We have the recording. So up first with the first senior speech will be Ava.
Hi, everyone. So I am going to be speaking about Stella. Alrighty. So, dear Stella, let me start by saying how absolutely gorgeous your voice is and how deeply it and you will be missed by this group. I remember the first time I heard it. My first emotion, to be honest, was jealousy, because how could somebody sound like a literal angel? Your high notes don't belong to this earth, and I hope you know that every person lucky enough to hear your voice gets a genuinely otherworldly experience. Then, to make it better, you're also a beautiful, intelligent woman. I don't use those words lightly, because come on, look at you. I know I comment under every single one of your Instagram pictures that you're glowing, and it's because it's true. You have such a beautiful glow that lights up every single room you walk into. I also remember going out to eat with you for the first time and thinking about how amazed I was by your dedication to the things you're passionate about. Basically, at that moment, you talked about your academics in a way that genuinely inspired me to pick a major that made me as passionate as you were. I have to thank you for that pivot in my life, and I don't think I ever told you that, but I want you to know that every positive and passionate thing you do has a positive effect on everyone around you, including me. Also, I remember walking with you on retreat. I learned how kind and genuinely willing to be vulnerable you are. We opened up to each other so easily, and I cherish those memories with you. Thank you for inspiring me to be my genuine self. I'm so lucky to have been graced by your presence these past couple of years, and I know your loved ones and friends have been too. Please don't ever forget your innate power, kindness, intelligence, and beauty. You are a gift to whichever field you foray into and stage you sing on. All love, Ava.
So I'll be speaking next. Hi, Stella. I've been lucky enough to be in this group with you for a couple years now. But for those of you who have not had the pleasure of meeting Stella and enjoying her light, I just wanted to tell you a couple things about her. So as you've heard, and as you're about to hear, this girl has not the voice of an angel, but better. I mean this in the most genuine way. Heaven, if I was in charge of heaven, I would have them hire you to replace all of the angels. But your voice makes complete sense as soon as you get to know you, because you are seriously one of the sweetest people I've ever met. Whenever I'm with you, I really can't help but smiling. I see your smile and it just gives me a smile every single time. Anyone else, if you know her, you know that you can't have a smile. And Stella, I know you're about to do so many amazing things, and you're gonna take that light and that sweetness with you everywhere you go and to everyone you meet. And I'm so jealous that those people will get to bask in your glow, but I will force you back uptown every single time to make us smile. Anyway, I'm going to miss you so much next year, and it makes me really, really sad that you have to graduate, but I really hope, and I Either way, we'll make you come back. So I love Stella.
Hi, everyone. All right, so I am also doing speech for Stella, or I get to be one who gets to speak on Stella, because you know, everybody in this group would love to. Okay. So, dear Stella, I'm so grateful that we all found a shared love with you in a cappella. During the rain of my freshman year, you would hand me an umbrella. Always working on so many cool projects, you're hella intella, gent. With the voice of an angel, but you're also so modest. With the energy of a goddess, but you're also so patient. All the memories we shared and the 2 years prior, I can't even imagine all the love that you've inspired. And it's sad here today that we've lost almost 2 years. Still, I won't be the first to say that you've made many friends here for life. We love you, Stella, and I can't bear to say goodbye. I won't even try. So this isn't goodbye.
And I, for those of you don't know me, I'm Tristan, and I will be somehow trying to finish off Stella's speech, which is hard to do without. Well, it's actually, we have to overstate. I was going to say it's hard to do without overstating, but no, we need to overstate these things about Stella. That between the glow, which covers not just her voice, not just her personality, not just her looks, but you know, certain people glow like, just radiate light. Stella radiates light and it touches everyone she interacts with. And I think it's also an understatement to say that everyone appreciates her like someone, like we would appreciate someone who emits light like that. And it's priceless. There's no way to really fully do it justice. But I think I'm speaking for everyone when I say we love you very much. And if you don't visit, we will be very, very, very sad.
So I'm assuming now it's time for me to talk. I am very emotional. I thank you guys so much. I am actually about to cry. But I'm gonna be singing Good Days by SZA a cappella. So for those of you who don't know the song, good luck. Yeah, I hope you guys like it. And thank you guys so much. I love all of you, genuinely. Yeah, thank you.
Good days in my mind, safe to take a step out, get some air now, let your edge out. Too soon I spoke, you'll be heavy in my mind. Can you get the heck out? I need a race now, got me bummed out. You, baby, 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 I'll be on my empty mind, shit. I try to keep from losing the rest of me. I worry that I wasted the best of me on you, babe. You don't care. Not trying to be a nuisance, it's just hurting. Trying to make sense of this change got me a war in my mind. Gotta let go away, can't keep what's holding me. Oh, watch, will the world break up and follow me? Oh, well, I'm a fade with a smile. I still wanna try to believe it. Good days. Tell me I'm not my fears, my limitations. I disappear if you let me. Feel like Jericho, feel like Job when I hold my shit, my cross to bear alone. Way to let, way to kill the moon. Oh, you like that, yeah. Not trying to be a nuisance, it's just hurting. Gonna make sense of this change. Got me a war in my mind. They can get one for me. All the while, gonna wake up and follow me. All the while, hoping my heart would fail with a smile. Still wanna try to believe it. God damn. Good days on my mind.
Stella, that was incredible. Yes.
That was so incredible.
Thank you for a beautiful, hopefully not the last time we hear you sing, but a beautiful absolutely goodbye not to Notes and Keys. I won't let it happen. That was absolutely stunning.
Forever good days in my mind.
Up next, we'll be having Samir with the next senior speech.
Yes, I have the privilege of getting to start off the speeches for our next senior, Vincent. First of all, I wanted to congratulate you, Vincent, for getting accepted to Cambridge for next year. I know you're going over there, and I think that I can speak for all of us when we say that that's an incredible accomplishment, and we're really proud of you for getting there, so I hope you have a lot of fun when you leave. And on beyond just your acceptance to Cambridge, it's been an absolute pleasure getting to sing with you the past couple of years. From sitting in Hamilton and watching Peter's random videos and during our bass sectionals to this past semester and having conversations with you in our little breakout rooms for basses, it's just been a really amazing couple years of NAC with you, and it's been really great getting to know you as a person because you're just such a calm and measured presence, and I think you're just a gift to all of us in this group. Your voice is one of the most unique voices I've ever heard in my life. I can remember when we went on retreat last year to Ursa's cabin, and all of the newbies were doing the tradition where we all sing our audition solos, and I'd actually never heard you sing by yourself. And then you sang like a Sinatra song or some old school song, and it blew my mind. It was like the craziest thing I'd ever heard because I'd never heard somebody with a voice like yours. And I think that, again, I can speak for all of us when we say that your voice is just insane and we're gonna miss hearing it every day in NAC. So make sure you keep singing when you go to England and you're doing all your masters in Cambridge, and you gotta send us videos, of course. And I think that beyond that, also, you've been very dedicated to NAC this year, and you really took on a leadership role, especially for us in the bass section. And it's really just helped us kind of get through this virtual year with you being a really sturdy presence, especially since we got in the same year and you really took up that mantle and really, took that leadership role. And it just really helped, I think, all of us stay engaged and stay focused with NAC. And it's just been, it's been really helpful. And I'm really happy that I got to experience that with you this year. And again, it was my pleasure to sing with you in Notes and Keys, and I hope that you stay in touch, and I hope that I can get dinner with you soon and talk about it. Have a good time in Cambridge, and we all love you so much.
Vincent, I just wanted to start off to say thank you for being such an amazing bass leader this semester. You are such a kind-hearted and genuine person, and I think something that I absolutely admire about you is your dedication to make sure that everyone feels included. And I feel, especially as a newbie this year and someone who's new to Notes and Keys, I feel like you've really made being a part of Notes and Keys such a special part of my, my first year at Columbia. I have absolutely enjoyed every single of our bass family dinners. I'm so glad we've had the opportunity to chat beyond just, rehearsals. And I'm also so thankful for your guidance during these during the semester when you've been leading each of our rehearsals, and I don't know what our section would be without you, because you have really been such a strong presence, and I really could not imagine my sophomore year without you. It feels like I'm a freshman sometimes. even though we haven't we've only known each other for a semester, sometimes it does feel like I've known you for a lifetime, because you really are just such an incredible human being. And I'm so, so happy I had the opportunity to meet you and Notes and Keys was able to bring us together. And I'm also really excited for the summer when you're finally able to visit, New York. In fact, I know that you are here, but like in quarantine. So when summer rolls around, I'm so excited for us to finally be able to grab dinner and maybe even visit Columbia's campus together. So thank you again for being such an amazing base father. And I'm so happy that we were able to, that Nose and Keys was able to bring us together.
Hi. Okay, so for those who don't know, Vincent was actually my secret Santa this year. And even though we were all at home, he mailed it to my house. It was a custom-made CD with a bunch of my favorite songs, as well as some of his favorite songs, one of which you're about to hear, with a Photoshop picture on the cover of some of my favorite celebrities and professors. And I'm telling you all of this so that you can have just a small idea of the care and thoughtfulness that Vincent puts into everything he does. I remember when you first auditioned for us and you started singing Fly Me to the Moon, and I knew in that very moment that I was gonna have to arrange the song just so that I could get to hear you sing it again. And even though you joined your junior year, it feels like you've been in Notes and Keys forever, which Jaron also said, but it's true. You're always ready with a witty joke to make us all laugh or to entertain us during check-ins with the latest episode of the movie that is your life. And business manager is a tough position to fill, but once you were elected, I knew that I had nothing to worry about. Staying on top of emails for Columbia's premier a cappella group is no small feat, and I genuinely don't know what I would have done without you this year. Just last week, I called Vincent in a panic about an arrangement that will remain unnamed, and he was able to calm me down, listening to me rant and then making me feel better by making me laugh about the situation. These are the qualities that make him one of the kindest people that I know, and I'm so, so thankful to have had the opportunity to sing alongside you. And as you go off to England next year and you become a true intellectual, I hope you remember us and all the nights we spent in Hamilton Hall going over the bass part for a song, or the late nights in JJ's when we probably should have been studying. I know that no one will miss you quite as much as the bass section, but I hope that you know how much your presence has been a gift to us all and how much we will truly miss you next year. Love you.
Thank you guys, that was all so nice.
Can I say something?
Wait, sorry, there's another one.
Is it okay? Oh, please, Vincent, is it okay if I...
Oh, I would love to hear this all day. Yeah, go ahead.
Thank you. Hi, me again. So once again, it's hard to wrap up the speech without, I don't know, repeating a lot of what's already been said about Vincent's fantastic qualities. I just want to say that he's someone I'm really happy to call my friend. He's just a really, I mean, we can talk about how great everyone is at singing, which they are all fantastic, but also all kind, genuine, good people. And Vincent, I'm just happy to call him my friend. I'm glad he's been able to hold down both the bass section and also our cash flow with the business manager position. He's really just a professional weapon. Whether he's hanging out with us during a section dinner or just hanging out with us in terms of just anywhere, it's the kind, sweet guy that we got to know. And when we don't know the part, he is very, very helpful when the time need be, when the time arises. Yeah, just we love you. And on the same level, we thank you. We thank you so much.
Thank you, everyone. All right, yeah, so as Maisie said, I will be singing a song I also put on her CD, which is called Little Star by The Elegants. Enjoy.
Where are you, little star? Tattoo. Twinkle
wish I might make this wish come true tonight. Searched all over for a love, you're the one I'm dreaming of. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder where you are. High above the clouds somewhere, send me down a love to share.
There. That was great. Wow. Way to
send it off with a bang.
Send it off with a bang. Exactly. Thank you, Vincent. That was really beautiful to listen to. So up next.
Oh, yeah. Happy belated birthday also to Vincent.
Happy birthday. So also we will now be moving on to the second recorded song of the night, mm-hmm. Grows Old. So Maisie, you can take it away.
Can I take your hand? Do you understand? You found my heart broken. You helped me make it whole. I'm starting to feel I found something real. The thought of you fills me with a warmth I've never known. Hold my heart till you
hold my heart.
that vibrato. Woo! So incredible. Dante, that was a little
shout out to the seniors who are growing old.
Growing so old. Oh, yeah, just so old. Okay, kicking it off with our next senior speech will be Colby.
I am so honored to be speaking about Nathan tonight. Although I've only known Nathan for a few months, he has already made a significant impact on my life. When I first joined Notes and Keys, I was incredibly intimidated by the sheer talent each and every member possesses. And this certainly went for Nathan. As you all know, Nathan is an incredibly gifted individual. His musical talent is nothing short of amazing. But something I didn't know before working with him is that his capacity for kindness is limitless. As soon as I started making music with Nathan, my apprehension about being part of a group of extremely talented individuals like Notes and Keys faded. Even working with him over Zoom, I felt completely supported and encouraged. I'm a firm believer in the idea that one of the ways your passion for something can be measured is by how you share that passion with others. By this standard, Nathan is a truly radiant individual. His love for music and everything Notes and Keys represents was remarkably evident in the time we spent making music together. Under his guidance, I've learned so much. He continually demonstrates the profound influence making music with others can have, even just over Zoom. And that is something I'll take with me for the rest of my life. Although a large part of the time I've spent with Nathan has been centered on musical creation, I found that his encouragement extends far beyond the realm of making music. It was so clear that he deeply cared for me, not just as a fellow musician, but as an individual. Navigating the Columbia environment is an immensely difficult task, especially if you enter it in a way that's entirely virtual, as I did this year. But every week, I really looked forward to our rehearsals as not only an outlet for making music with extremely talented people, but as a place where I could look for advice and support. As the leader of our tenor section, Nathan did such an amazing job ensuring that our rehearsals were a supportive space to ask questions not only about music, but about Columbia and about life in general. I want him to know how grateful I am for this kindness and guidance. I am tremendously proud to be his friend, and I am so excited to see what his future holds. Nathan, congratulations and thank you.
Colby, that was a beautiful speech. Oh my goodness. So I'll be going next. So Nathan, one of my earliest memories with you is my freshman year when we were walking around Ferris. And I'm not entirely sure what triggered it, but you let out your incredible one-of-a-kind laugh, the laugh that everyone here knows about, that caught everyone's attention. And for a moment, we just looked at each other. But you laughed it off, and soon enough, I was laughing, and the two of us were laughing even more than what had already started. And I think about that moment often when I think of you, because I think it's one of the first moments that made me admire your ability to be truly yourself, and how through our friendship, like, that's allowed me to do the same. One of the many things I love about you is your incredible ability to radiate such a positive energy whenever you're around people, that your laugh becomes infectious. And I could go on and on about how talented your voice is, and I know you're going to become famous, but what really makes you special, Nathan, is your big heart. And you have one of the biggest hearts I've ever seen. And I love that you love to make other people smile. I love how thoughtful you are. I love the way you consider other people and their feelings, the way you encourage people to be their best selves, and so much more. My college experience, Notes and Keys and this campus would not be the same without you. I love you so much, Nathan. I know you'll do great things. Congratulations.
Nathan, we love you. We can't even express how much we love you. I may or may not have another poem. This one is for Nathan. So, dear Nathan, I'm not known for metaphor, but I'll try for a good rhyme. Your presence is like a good wine. It only gets better with time. When you laugh, it's like the sun when the sun shines. The whole room lights up. We all get starstruck when Maisie hits you with the mic. It's sultry tones, breath control, and the riffs when you go high. It's an unreal sight. You're so good with your voice, it's a public service. On the day I met you, I'll admit I was nervous. Part of my design in trying to join Notes and Keys was to find out how you make your voice move the way you do. It's crazy. Close up, I was surprised, partially because you're so nice and partially because you're so kind. And every rehearsal, every time that you started to sing, your heart would shine, and it blows my mind. Your talent and spirit are so aligned. Your presence is like the wind when it's hot outside. It blows us away, and it's a perfect delight. Just as bright, just as right, every time. I guess that's our time then. You'll be missed, my friend. We love you to the stars and around the bend. Never stop shining.
Okay, wow, my one doesn't rhyme. That was really good. Okay, so the first time that I met Nathan was during NSOP, when I went up to him because he had taken a video of me in a packed Carmen elevator and I wanted to see it. And I'm sure that other people can relate when I talk about the experience of the first time hearing Nathan's laugh. I know that Chloe can. It's pretty memorable. And most importantly, it makes you laugh too. I was so happy when, a week later, I saw him in the a cappella audition room and we were able to continue bonding over our shared understanding of the niche experience of growing up in New Jersey and doing jazz. Since then, I have had the extreme honor of getting to sing alongside this marvel of musical talent every week, but even more than that was the honor of getting to become your close friend. From all the time spent on the lawns and in JJ's for all of our gigs and rehearsals, you have been a constant presence in all of our lives, and you never fail to bring that classic Nathan energy to the group. Even this year, with Zoom rehearsals and you being busier than ever as a senior, you still make time to see me and help me out with all of my music theory questions, and you're always there to obsess with me over Cecile McLaurin-Savant. I look forward to the day when we're able to see you perform live again, because those have been some of my all-time favorite memories from college. From the famous SoFar concert, I don't know if everyone knows, but Nathan did a SoFar concert, to your club coming performance with Kat Cohen, to your gig last March when you announced that they were canceling school from the stage. I think one of the reasons why people love coming to your gigs, besides getting to hear your incredible talent singing and songwriting and playing saxophone, is that it is just such a joy to watch you perform. You are so genuine and confident, and you always know how to impress a crowd. I would literally camp outside of a venue if it meant that I got to hear Nathan perform live again, and I'm sure that someday I'll have to. Through and through, you have been a musical inspiration to me, and I hope you know that you have created a new challenge for me, which is to arrange a song that instantly becomes a Knack classic, the way that you did when you arranged How Deep Is Your Love. I'm not sure if you will ever understand how much you have done for Notes and Keys, or the individual impacts that you have had on every member that has been lucky enough to be in the group at the same time as you, but at the very least, I hope you know how much I appreciate having had the chance to know you. And although I will certainly miss your voice, your laugh, and your riff on Best Part, those are all just parts of the incredibly accomplished person that I have watched you become over the past 3 years. Nathan, I love you so, so, so much, and I cannot wait to see what you'll go on to do, because I know that it's going to be great.
Thank you guys so, so much. I'm very overwhelmed. Yeah, I wasn't expecting that. Thank you so, so much. We'll talk later. So I guess my song now I pre-recorded a John Mayer song that I was kind of vibing out to, that I felt like kind of, I don't know, this kind of captured my space. I was just kind of in the John Mayer headspace for the past couple of weeks. So yeah, this is Dreaming with a Broken Heart.
Dreaming with a broken heart, the waking up is the hardest part. You roll out of bed and down on your knees, and for a moment you can hardly breathe, wondering, was she really? Is she standing in my room? No, she's not.
'cause she's gone, 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 gone. When you're dreaming with a broken heart, the giving up is the hardest part.
The hardest part.
She takes you in with her crying eyes. Then all at once you have to say goodbye, wondering could you stay? Will you wake up? Will you wake up by my side?
Will you wake up by my side?
No, she can't, 'cause she's gone, gone, gone.
Okay, Nathan. Give us the arrangement.
Yeah, it is up with the arrangement. just so you know, I do own that video and I will play it too many times per day. Thank you very much for that.
Yeah, so thank you so much, Nathan. That was absolutely beautiful. Continuing on with the rest of our senior speeches, we have Jaren up first.
So today I'll be talking a little bit about Uwa. And first I would like to congratulate her on her admissions to Oxford for a graduate program. She's among her many talents as a musician. She's also a great intellectual, and we are also proud of her for her accomplishments. I'd also like to just say that, Uwa, you have such an amazing voice. I literally had chills during the entirety of the best part, and your tone is absolutely gorgeous, and it was a blessing to be able to listen to you sing. But in addition to her amazing voice, she has so many other incredible qualities, and one of them is her sense of humor. You are literally one of the funniest people I have ever met, and your enthusiasm and vivacity during rehearsals always brings a smile to my face. And oftentimes I'll find myself laughing until I literally cannot breathe during our rehearsals, and you have such a radiant energy that really lights up any room and always brings a smile to my face. But beyond your sense of humor, I think that you are one of the most thoughtful and sweet people that I have ever had the honor of meeting. During rehearsals, I know that she would periodically, you know, send me private messages just asking how I've been doing. And these small moments really have made my day because it's just so nice just to hear or get those messages from her on those occasions. Although I'm sad that we were never able to meet in person this semester, I'm so excited for when you finally get to visit us during this coming school year or sometime in the future. You are an absolute icon, and thank you for being such a talented and amazing music director. And I genuinely look forward to the day that we meet. And I'm also so excited to tell my kids that I knew you when you become rich and famous, and I'm so glad that I had the opportunity to meet you. We will miss you dearly next year, and I can't wait to hear about you on the news. Love you, Uwa.
I'll be going next. Dear Uwa, while I've only known you for a semester and I've met you in person maybe two or three times, the fact that I feel and felt so comfortable with you the times that we've met, and that I already know you as this amazingly kind, hilarious, as Jaren said, intelligent person, it's just a testament to the type of person you are. You're absolutely one of a kind, and I am so glad I had the privilege of meeting you this year. I told you this, I guess, yesterday, but yes, I actually started following you on Instagram my sophomore year in high school, years before I'd get into Columbia and join Notes and Keys, simply because, you know, like an angel that fell out of the sky, you happened to fall onto my Explore page, and I fell in love with your voice and talent. And everyone and their mother knows it. Your voice is impeccable, smooth as butter, whatever. It gives me chills every time I hear it. But more than being, you know, an incredible singer, as everyone knows, songwriter, arranger, musician, whatever, you have the most beautiful spirit and just seem like one of the best people to be around. You're so kind, so funny, above all, so humble. Even through Zoom, you light up the virtual room with your spirit. So I've loved getting to meet you, seeing your face on Zoom and sob sectionals, laughing way too hard at your jokes so loud that my Zoom has to tell me that I'm muted. I so wish we could have gotten more time together this year, but I'm super excited for you. You're going to do such incredible things in England with music, with your studies. I just hope we can meet sometime soon again, write some music together. Congratulations, Uwa, you're going to kill it.
Hi, Uwa. Okay, so I have two goals. First is to keep it short. Second is to not cry. We will see how both of those go. So while I was thinking about what I wanted to say, you know, classic, where do I go? Where do I start? So figure we'll go from the beginning. And this is a big taboo for giving a speech about someone else, but I'm gonna start with an anecdote about myself. Freshman year, got to college, got to Columbia. I auditioned for NAC in the first week, and I am so grateful to have gotten in because the past 3 years have been absolutely incredible. And I remember after I got in the first night, I got a bunch of texts from people already in the group the next day trying to convince me to choose NAC. And that was really confusing to me because I hadn't auditioned for any other groups. I didn't even really think about it that much. I didn't even realize it was a thing that people auditioned for multiple groups. Like, I hadn't even really pondered it because by the time I got to Columbia's campus, I had already made up my mind. And the reason why is because record scratch, I lied, that wasn't actually the beginning. The real beginning was my senior year of high school, first time I ever went to Columbia was for days on campus. And my guide was Miss Uwa. And so she's leading me around campus and showing me things, and it's great. And part of the way through the night, she says, I actually have to go. I'm gonna leave you with someone. I just have something that I have to do. And I'm like, okay, that's fine. And so the sort of progression of the day leads all of the new students to the sort of a cappella showcase. And I listened to Notes and Keys sing. And this is big honor in case anyone in the audience has heard. First, I listened to Tommy sing Unsteady, and that was almost the selling point right there on its own. And then I listened to Uwa sing Evergreen, and that is when I decided there is no other group that I want to be in. And I'm pretty sure I obnoxiously texted you over the summer, like trying to figure out what to sing, all of that. So it really was, it's been since day one that your voice has genuinely shaped my experience at Columbia in a way that I am so grateful for. And then the best part was that after getting the privilege to listen to you sing, I got to get to know you once I joined NAC. And I have looked up to you since the first day of rehearsal. You are limitlessly talented. You are hilarious. You have this simultaneous gentleness and command of the room, and your presence is just grounding, and it's stunning, and it's beautiful, and I'm really just, woof, here I go. I'm so grateful to have been able to know you over the past 3 years, because you have just been an absolute light in my life in dark times and in bright times, and it breaks my heart that I'm not going to be able to sing with you again, but it makes it worth it to know that I know that you're going to go and do absolutely incredible things, and I'm so excited to watch you do those things and listen to the music that you produce, because it comes from such a stunning, beautiful place. And I just want you to know that you have indisputably made NAC what it is for everyone that has been, like, that has literally just had the privilege of being able to be in this group while you are here. That's probably me almost crying and almost going too long. So I will stop here, but I just want to say thank you for your, like, thank you for your voice and your music and your spirit and your kindness. You're genuinely one of the most incredible people I have the privilege to call my friend. Whew, here we go. Someone cut me off.
Oh, that's good. That put me on the verge of tears, Sydney. I'm going to cry. No, I'm not gonna, okay, I'm just gonna go. Uwa, I think that there are very few people over the past 4 years who have guided me with as much grace, thoughtfulness, and kindness as you. I still remember the first time I met you during my special Notes and Keys callback, and I was moved by your voice, as I still am, but little did I know that you as a friend would move me more. I don't think you've realized this, but after every time you did a crazy dance move with me or entertained my idea that I have perfect pitch, which I don't, and you know this because I've tried proving it to you many, many times, I would remind myself how lucky I am to know you and to call you a friend. When I'm sad, you dance with me. When I'm stressed, you talk it out with me. And when I'm tired, you make me laugh so hard I have to excuse myself from the room. But you've been more than a good friend. You've been someone who I have consistently and will continue to truly admire. I admire the way you approach things with both your head and your heart, your unbounding grace and kindness, and the way you make every person around you feel at home with you. I've known from early on you were someone I would look up to, and I hope that we would become close enough for me to one day express my gratitude for everything you've given to me. And I'm glad I finally have the chance to do so publicly, because everyone deserves to know how special of a person you truly are. I can't thank you enough for everything you've given me. I can't wait to see what you do in the world, and I know it'll be great. I haven't forgotten that I'm your fake manager, so you can't get rid of me yet. but I love you, Uwa, and you really are the best.
You are all too kind. Wow, thank you. Thank you so much. I wasn't expecting to be smiling so hard, and now it's gonna be hard to sing, but you know what? Let's do it. I made this decision to do it live. Can you help me? So I will be singing a song from a movie that's dear to me called Ratatouille. This is Le Festin by Camille, and it is a French song, but I am told that someone will be copying and pasting the translation to the chat so that everyone understands it. Yes, because it's very beautiful and very emotional. Okay. All right.
Spire comme la bien entrevue.
Thank you. And that's a wrap, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Notes and Keys. All my love to you. Good night, everyone.
Well, are you kidding me?
That was beautiful.
I can't.
Two types of people know that song, TikTok and Ratatouille. And let's talk about it.
And the educated.
Who was the first fan of Ratatouille before it was viral? Okay, thank you so much, Uwa. That was absolutely beautiful.
So much. For our last senior of the night, we have Sydney starting us off.
Anagha. As we discovered yesterday, our first interaction was so pure. For those of you not in our Instagram DMs, it started like this. Hi, my name's Sydney, and I'll be an incoming freshman at Barnard this year. I saw you on the NAC story, which encouraged me to reach out with some questions. You responded, hey, Sydney, thanks so much for reaching out, with a ton of smiley faces. Not super sure how I gained the confidence to reach out to an incoming senior when I hadn't even been on campus, but it was clear from the beginning that you had such a kind soul that deeply cared about this group, making sure I felt comfortable during the entire audition process. We soon FaceTimed after. I was incredibly nervous. I had seen your talent on the Instagram and knew I was in the presence of a superstar. I left that phone call feeling calmer than ever and knew NAC was the place for me. You spoke of late nights at rehearsals, gigs all around the city, and the family the group provided for you. You talked about Lin-Manuel Miranda and his apartment, retreat in the woods, and obligatory post-rehe JJs. I was beyond excited when I got into the group, not only because of all the other wonderful people in it, but because I would get to know you better, and you are an absolute source of light. Some of my favorite moments with you are watching you walk into a room and everyone gasp, Anagha, beyond excited to see you. Your effect on this group has been tremendous, but in no way ends tonight. I can't wait to call you with econ questions as you continue to pitch me the major, visit you while you take on the world of finance, and watch While We Were Young over and over again. A fashion icon and top tier listener, Anagha, I will miss you more than you know. Thank you for welcoming me with open arms, laughing at my jokes, and giving me priceless professional and personal advice. You have no idea how much I appreciate it and you. I love you so much, Anagha. You truly are bold and beautiful, and I can't wait to see what's in store for you. Endless love and congratulations.
Okay, so I'm also speaking for Anagha. All right, I'm also gonna just really keep it together because to the public, Anagha and I have witty banter where we pretend that we don't like each other. So I'm going to pretend and try to keep it in as my tears inevitably flow either now or later tonight. So, dear Anagha, one of my very first memories of you was in one of our first big meetings in Notes and Keys. You were Madam President, and you said, quote, when I wake up, I think of NAC, and when I fall asleep, I think of NAC, unquote. Not gonna lie, it sounded a little crazy. I was new to the group, and I remember I was a little weirded out, but I also thought, wow, this girl is the glue of this group. And it was true. Ever since I was a newbie, freshman, and you were a junior, I looked up to you for your ability to bring everyone together. You have dedicated endless hours and weekends and nights to this group, and I know every single one of us is grateful for it. NAC would not have been the same without you, the first Madam President I was lucky enough to come across, and I know that your guidance helped me help make me a better person, musician, and friend. On top of that, I was lucky enough to get to know you outside of NAC as well. I do not exaggerate when I say that it is genuinely stunning to know that there are people as kind, hilarious, okay, smart, accomplished, and beautiful inside and out as you are. These past 2 years of knowing you have been nothing but a privilege. It's very sad to know that my Columbia experience won't have you on campus with me, but I'm comforted by the fact that you will be in my life and in this city. You are not only a role model for your character, but also for your accomplishments. I'm lucky to have such a strong woman to look up professionally, somebody to ask about jobs, and somebody to laugh about the stressful moments involved in career-related stuff. You're going into a field extremely lucky to have found somebody like you, hardworking and yet genuinely kind. Anyways, please don't mention that I said all of these nice things ever again, and we can go back to roasting each other, because if I start talking about how much I love you, I genuinely will never stop, and I can't wait to have more years in the city with you, Ratatouille.
Okay, shut up. Okay. Okay. Okay.
composing myself, because this is like, this is messed up. Also, like, as a person who doesn't show emotion, this is so messed up that I am like, wow, channeling every power I have right now. Okay. I feel like we have not had enough time together, because every second I have with you, I just like, I appreciate so much. Anyway, stop, Chloe. Okay. Okay. Oh my, I'm not even into the speech. You are genuinely one of the best people I have met at Columbia. So I find it really, really annoying that you have to leave. When I joined Notes and Keys, I remember being very intimidated by you. I'm crying. Anyway. Okay, 1 second, everyone. I was like, who is this smart? It's because I'm looking at you. Can I like not look at her? How do I not look at her? Okay. It's because I was like, who is this smart, gorgeous girl? And then she had this ethereal voice. And then like I heard her speaking and I was like, she's funny too? Like, are you kidding me? Like, what the? So to talk about your voice, I mean, literally you do not need the hype, because if people do not know, they are certifiably deaf. I mean, every time you open your mouth, I could cry, and I don't think you understand how literally I mean that. Like, I say that as a joke, like, all the time, but, like, I mean that, like, shockingly, genuinely, like, in its entirety. When you, like, laugh sing, like, we were in dress rehearsal last night, and she was, like, laugh singing her song, and, like, here I am with goosebumps, and she's like, yeah, I'm just gonna stop, like, haha, and I'm, like, about to cry. So this is my formal request to, I'm gonna send you a playlist of about 10 songs. You're gonna have to record them for me so that I can just like play them next year whenever like I need them, you know? Okay, thanks. So back to when I met you, I was definitely a bit scared, but then as soon as I started talking to you, I was like, what am I doing? This girl's hilarious. She's so fun. She's so chill. Seriously, you make me laugh so hard, like probably the most out of anyone at Columbia. And so please don't be surprised. It's like midday, you're busy. You're being a sick working woman. Like, you're doing so many different things, but I'm just gonna call you. Please pick up. 30 seconds, a minute, all I need for a good laugh. Seriously, I'm so sorry, everyone, but Anagha, I'm going to kill you, because you are all of these things and more, and you are so humble. Like, you are not aware of how much you mean to this group. Like, yes, like, everyone, like, makes fun of Anagha because, like, exactly quotes, like, I wake up, I think of Nak, I go to sleep, I think of Nak, like, Anagha loves Nak more than anything, but you don't even know, because we don't say it enough, because you're the probably most emotional one of this group. Now, right now, I look like it, which is ironic, but you, like, you think that you love Nak. Nak loves you so much more. Like, you bring a heart to this family, and we would not be the same group without you, and I can confidently say that as cheesy as it is, I would not be the same person without you. You're a ridiculous inspiration, and I know with not one doubt that you're about to go off into like God knows how many incredible things. Okay, I shed a tear. I can't read. Like, I feel I can hear my roommates laughing at me. I feel like I should be able to send a memo to your company and all your future coworkers, because they're like not ready. I mean, I hate them. I hate them. I entered our office because I'm so jealous that they're getting you, and they don't even know how lucky they are, but they really should. So anyway, I'm gonna miss you so much, and if I have to drag you uptown, I will, because you will not be escaping this. This is not a college friendship. This is my formal warning to you. This is not a college friendship. You cannot escape, exactly, yeah. And so I really just wanna thank you for being you, and for being alive at the same time as me, and for joining NAC, because I can't imagine what my past years would have been like without you. Okay, I love you, I'm going off camera.
Okay, I don't know how I'm gonna follow that. Love you, Sabrina. Okay, so, Anagha. Those familiar with Notes and Keys know that we have a pretty extensive audition process that at the end involves a full day of callbacks. And I remember my freshman year when I spent all day in the Broadway first floor lounge being so nervous to interact with anyone and everyone in Notes and Keys. And at the end of callbacks, members at the time spoke about why they chose to join the group, and we do this every year. And every year I always think that Anagha has the best answer. She always talks about how, even though it's such a cliche, that Notes and Keys is a family, it's true. As a freshman, I could only imagine what she was talking about, but now, 3 years later, I know just how real it is. Anagha, I can't believe it's gotten to this point already. It feels like just yesterday that I went up to you at the first Notes and Keys party and told you that you reminded me of my sister. And since then, I've been so lucky to have you as one of my best friends, both in Notes and Keys and at Columbia. From our weekly dates at Hungarian, to studying on campus or late nights on the steps, from our movie nights to our walks in Central Park, and our very short-lived TikTok career. I can't tell you how much you mean to me and how much I'm going to miss seeing your face at rehearsal. Now, I couldn't make a speech about Anagha without talking about her voice, because, oh my God, she might just be the most talented singer I know. The soprano section will not be the same without your angelic voice, nor will the rest of the group. You were always someone that I could count on during rehearsals and gigs, and I'm really gonna miss looking across to see you during concerts. I'm not sure if you know this, but when I first joined the group, I was so intimidated by you and how amazing you were. And while I'm no longer intimidated by you, I can say for sure that you have become one of my role models. When I look back at my time at Columbia, it will be Notes and Keys that I remember the most, and my time would not have been the same without you. Anagha, you always say that Notes and Keys is a family, but I really need you to know that you are the reason why that statement is true for so many of us. I love you so, 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 so much. I don't know what I'm gonna do without you next year. Although, since you'll be in the city, you can be sure that I'm gonna hit you up to go get Hungarian so you won't be rid of me yet. I love you.
Anagha, I'm quite honestly dreading this moment because I don't wanna believe that this is finally the time I give you your senior speech. We've joked and spoken about this so many times, but we've also joked that you're secretly in my grade, so it was a bit of a toss-up. You've meant so much to me over these past 3 years. I can't even begin to describe it in a short speech like this, but I'll try my best. When I first joined Notes and Keys, I wasn't sure what to expect. I didn't know what the group would be like, if people would like me, but from the very first rehearsals, I knew I really liked you and I wanted to become your friend. I didn't know you would become one of my best friends. That would become so close we could stay up all night just talking to each other about our lives, going in and out of deep talks to laughing so hard we have to take 10-minute breaks before we continue. And this is all just in the first semester. Last year, I was lucky enough to be your VP and I saw you in a totally different light. You are an incredible leader and your humility surrounding that baffles me, because if people knew how much work and thought you put into Notes and Keys, work and thought that you still put into Notes and Keys, I don't think they'd be able to handle the idea that someone can be so intelligent, so funny, and so beautiful inside and out. You've made me feel so at home, so comfortable with you that I trust you with everything. I don't take any of our moments that we've spent together for granted. This is your fault that I'm crying for granted.
You're literally laughing. No. Good. It's a defense mechanism.
I know I would not be the person I am today without you. I have no doubt about that. We've grown together. We've understood each other. We've been there for each other. And you've been one of the people I've kept closest to my heart. I hope you understand how special you are. These speeches have only begun to scratch at the surface of how much you mean to every member of Notes and Keys. You are the glue that holds Notes and Keys together, and you have been since my freshman year. Not only myself, but the entire group would not be what it is without you. I've seen you transform from someone I do the dance from Us, the movie, if anyone knows that dance, with around campus, to a mom and friend to the freshman now, and I'm so proud of you and everything you've accomplished. You're one of the most special people I've ever met, Anagha. I love you so dearly. You're an incredible person, an incredible friend, and I know you're going to do incredible things in your life. Love you. You're really the best, and to finish it off, thank you for being the friend that's taught me about friendship and for being the friend that made me who I am. Thank you so much. And I love you so much.
I really should have pre-recorded this because that was I love you guys so much. I love you guys a lot. I don't know what else to say. Honestly, that left me pretty speechless, but.
We love you too.
Yeah. I'm gonna sing Lay Me Down by Sam Smith.
guys. Okay. That was so much. Okay. Give me 2 seconds.
Yes, I do. I believe that one day I will be where I was, right there, right next to you. And it's hard. Days just seem so dark. The moon, the stars are nothing without you. Your touch, your skin, where do I begin? No words can explain the way I'm missing you. Deny this emptiness, this hole that I'm inside. These tears, they tell their own story. They told me not to cry when you were gone. Feeling is overwhelming, it's much too strong. Can I lay by your side next to you? I'll take care of you. And I don't want to be here if I can't be with you tonight. I'm reaching out to you. Can you hear my call? This hurt that I've been through, I'm missing you. I'm missing you like crazy. Can I lay by your side next to you? And make sure you're all right. I'll take care of you. And I don't want to be here if I can't be with you tonight. Lay me down tonight. Lay me by your side. Lay me down tonight. Lay me by your side. Can I lay by your side next to you?
Okay, love you guys.
Woo! Woo!
Oh my God, where's the Zoom? Where's the Zoom?
Where is it?
Oh. What? Wait, our Zoom is like freaking out.
Oh my God, what is happening?
Wait, stop. That's
it's Anagha's fault.
Okay, I'm kind of glad that I can't.
Look who's crying
Zoom.
Now.
I've recovered. But here's the thing, we can't see the Zoom.
Yeah.
Or like anything. Zoom. Oh wait,
we should have muted.
We see.
Okay.
Hi, Anagha. That was beautiful. I'm not crying. Just
well, I stopped and she started. A little bit. So
nasal today.
Ironic. Morissette said.
Yeah. Okay. Give us 1 second while we pull this up.
Okay, so okay. There's something weird that happens when we try to share this, but
we will now be to finish off the concert.
We have a special gift from the seniors to everyone here. I don't know if this has been done before, but the seniors did a song together. They're singing Goodbye Yellow Brick Road. So if you're not already crying, you will be crying by the end of this. So I'm going to share my screen and you'll watch me open this. It's so weird. Okay. Maisie, I think you have to like mute me because I can't see. Wait.
Pardon her.
We're just making sure we're sharing sound as well. Okay, we're doing it
all
again.
Right.
We're doing it again.
Here. Yeah, you got it. Cool. It's shared.
Good. Okay, all right. Here's our senior song.
Enjoy.
Going back to my dad.
sorts.
Encore of sorts.
Encore of sorts. Encore of sorts. Okay, we have an encore of sorts.
Sure. That sounded beautiful. Shout out to the seniors. Shout out to Christina for mixing that. Go off, queen. You made that sound absolutely incredible. You would have thought that was professional.
All right, now I'm going to share my screen for our encore of sorts. Little sweet treat, seniors. One second. I'm so sorry.
Let me photograph you in this light. love you, senior.
Wait.
Oh, you.
Did that echo? Oh, it is me. Woo! We love you guys so much. You are the best senior class we could ever ask for. I'm so happy you all got to hear just a portion of how much you mean to all of us, because we could not fit it into these speeches. We love you all so much. You've been the best leaders of Notes and Keys we could ever ask for. Thank you for making however like amount of time you spent with each member of Notes and Keys memorable and special. We love you. You guys are the absolute best.
Love you infinitely. And you're not getting rid of us just because you're graduating.
True.
That. That's a threat.
We're not dying. Please. Okay.
And that's a wrap.
That's a wrap.
Congrats, grads.
That was the senior concert. We love your offices.
Yeah, remember that.
Annika, your office is bouncing.
Remember that.
Hey, all right. Thank you so much, everyone, for coming. I'm going to end the call now, but
woo!
We love you.
Ow!
Bye.
Bye. Bye.